Good morning, students. Hello, everyone. Today we are going to discuss class 9th, chapter 3, elementary concepts of objects and classes. As in the previous day, we have discussed what is class, what is an object, different attributes and behavior of an object. Today we are going to discuss class as a user-defined data type, page number 35 and page number 36. Class as a user-defined data type. See students, we have already discussed what is a class. Class is a collection of objects of same kind having similar features. User-defined. User-defined means that anything that is defined by the user. User is a person who is working on the computer. We can also say that the person who is creating the programs, whether complex program or whether a simple program, that person is called a user. Data type. Data type means the type of data used in a program. Type of data means whether we are using the integer data, that is whole number without decimal point, or we are using the float data, that is with decimal point. Clear? So, whether we are using the with decimal point or whether we are using without decimal point, int or float, they all come in the category of data type. We are having character data type also for taking single character or multi character, and Boolean data type also to take the answer in the form of true or false. So, in the data type category, we are having two basic data types, that is primitive data type and derived data type. In the primitive data type, we have discussed in 8th standard also, Java provides 8 primitive fundamental data types, example int, char, float, etc. Primitive and fundamental means these are built-in data types in Java and we will use these data types in our program. But in this data type, we will take only single value at a time. If we will write int a is equal to 10, Int is a data type, a is a variable, and 10 is a value that we have given to a. But if we will write new value in a in place of 10, we have written 15, so the previous value will be erased. See the next point. Java also allows to create own data type using the primitive type and known as composite data type, means we will give our own name to the data type, but that data type will mate with the help of basic data types and their name is composite data type. As composite data type defined by the user, these are also called user defined data type. So what is the other name of composite data type? User defined data type, that is defined by the user. See the example students, int my integer. Now int is a system defined data type, that is built-in data type, and my integer is a variable of type int. We can write any name in place of my integer. We can write int a also, int b also, any variable name we can take in place of my integer. So int is a data type and my integer is a variable of type int. See the next example, account. Account is a user defined data type now. Means we have taken a data type account that is user defined and my account is a variable of type account. My account is an object name and account is a class name. So how we can say that account, my account, account is a class and my account is an object of type account. So students, we can say that using the concept of a class, we can make the data and methods of an object a user defined data type. The class may be considered as a data type and object as a variable of data type. The example we have discussed in previous slide, once the account class has been created or define, the following statement will create a my account object belonging to the account class. See, account is a class and my account is a object of account class. So students, today we have discussed the terms user defined, anything that is defined by the user, and data type. Next term, the type of data used in a program. So today we have discussed class as a user defined data type, page number 35. Students, revise this topic carefully, follow the examples, and in the next video we will come with next pages. Thank you very much.